I think we've seen a tremendous amount of progress in a short period of time. Unlike times past when we have seen protests erupt in our country since Trayvon Martin, Mike Brown, I've seen a change of thinking and language.
We'll fight with us. And so today,
does it mean that it will happen immediately? Does it mean that many of them may not have been speaking so that they would not be called out? I'm not sure, but the fact that they're raising the question is a significant difference.
We witnessed this horrific killing of George Floyd. We've seen countless horrific deaths, and now people are understanding what Malcolm was talking about. And they're understanding that Malcolm was a very much a young, compassionate, responsible man who was seeking solutions. And so people are now understanding that those who would do these horrific deaths are the ones who sometimes wrote the stories of who Malcolm was, this misinformation.
It's even more relevant today than it was 50 or 60 years ago. The quest for the unity of all Africans is not an end in itself, but a means for Africans to regain our dignity. That objective will be arrived at quicker if the 1.5 billion Africans, that is Africans in the continent and Africans in the diaspora, work together. Because the stronger the African voice becomes, the more racism will be diminished.